The notice to leave has been sent and the clock is ticking, but your tenants don't appear to be looking for anywhere to go. And you start to ask yourself, what happens if they don't leave? It's a frightening thought, particularly if you have planned to move back into your home or you've sold it to somebody who wants to move in. The majority of tenants do take a notice to leave very seriously and they start their search early. In fact, in some cases, a tenant will ask to leave earlier than the handover date once they have secured a property. And then, well, then there are other tenants who leave everything until the last minute. Perhaps they think you'll change your mind. Perhaps they are trying to get another home, but due to poor payment history or notice to remedy breaches, they're being declined on other properties. Or perhaps they just don't think you'll go through with getting them out. Whatever the reason, here's what you need to know. You can threaten to send the heavies around. I've heard this many times over the years. If they don't get out, I've got a few mates that I can send over. This is illegal, and the only person who will get into trouble is you. Upon handover date on the notice to leave, if the keys are not returned, an urgent application to QCAT will need to be made for failure to vacate. Upon receiving the paperwork, the courthouse will schedule a hearing date, at which point you or your property manager, if you have one, will appear along with your tenant. Provided that your documentation has been correctly completed and the notice periods allowed, the magistrate will order a warrant for possession. Think that's it? Think again. The warrant is sent to the local police and must come into effect within 3 days of being issued. However, the police are given up to 14 days, sometimes longer, to enforce the warrant. In my personal experience, the police are really busy and they're simply hoping that your tenant leaves on their own accord. For that reason, the warrant is not normally enforced until close to the 14-day expiry. Many tenants are rattled by the experience, and the thought of having the boys in blue arrive at the door sees them simply pack up and leave. If they don't, the police will ask you or your property manager to attend the property with them on a certain day, and they will obtain the keys from your tenant. In some cases, if there are still possessions inside the home, they will ask that you allow your tenant the day to remove their belongings before you return to lock up. All in all, it can be a harrowing ordeal, and typically you're left with a substantial cleanup. So, what can you do to avoid this? I'd love to say just choose the right tenant, but even great tenants can get themselves into a pickle. In our next video, we're going to discuss landlord insurance and the biggest misconceptions that investors have. So, don't forget to subscribe.